Welcome back to my channel. Oh, hi, do you want to say hi? So it is Thursday today, and you guys saw yesterday, Wednesday, I posted my DIY holiday ornaments video, and it was just a cozy at-home video. So this is kind of be another one of those cozy at-home videos. So I was actually at the thrift store, actually a couple of weeks ago. I've been holding on to this little goodie and little find for a little while. So I found this. I don't know what it is. Maybe it was a planner of some kind at some point. It was $2.99. So I was thinking that I would make her into a macrame plant hanger. I've been wanting to add a plant to my kitchen for a while, so I think that this is gonna be really pretty once it has some macrame around it. And since this is kind of so intricate and kind of busy, I think we'll keep the macrame pattern pretty simple, which is both easier to follow and cheaper because you're gonna use less macrame, hopefully. So let me show you where I'm thinking that I wanna put it in the kitchen, and then we'll go see how much macrame I actually have. So I wanna put it in the kitchen, and I'm thinking I wanna put it up here so it hangs down right kind of in that dead space over there, but it's not too close to the window. You know, just like, imagine it right there. Okay, so this is all the macrame that I have. I hope it's enough. And I brought my ladder in here, my blanket ladder, so that I could hook my macrame planter hanger on here to get it started, because you gotta hang it to work with it. I was watching some videos, and Emily Faith does some amazing macrame videos. If you guys haven't checked her out, I'll link her channel below. And she's done a couple of plant hangers too, and I was watching her make the gathering knot. She explained it really well. So we're gonna be doing that knot along with a spiral knot, I'm thinking. I'm gonna kinda go with the creativity as it comes to me. First thing, we gotta cut our macrame. I'm gonna need 6 strands, 10 foot each, because they're gonna be doubled, so it's gonna hang 5 foot down to start from the top, and then we're probably gonna make it 2.5 feet shorter when we knot it all up, so it's gonna finish around 3 feet, right? Okay, you're in my way. Okay, so we're going to fold the strands in half, all of them together. So we're gonna end up with a loop at the top, and then the strands are going to be 5 foot long. So I'm gonna hang this right in the middle on my hook, and it is easiest if you do macrame while it's hanging. Okay, so now we're gonna do the gathering knot to hold all of those strands together. So we're gonna need, this is what I haven't done before, we're gonna need more than enough strands, so maybe like 2 feet of yarn, new yarn, looped it like a teardrop up with one end short and the other with the rest of the yarn. Put it right on the top of all of your other strands, and we're gonna kind of hold it in place. And then using your long piece, you're gonna start wrapping around and keeping that little tail exposed. So wrap around. Until you get all the way down to the bottom of that loop, that teardrop that we made. Once you have it all the way down, almost done, you're gonna loop from the top to the bottom through that little loop, that teardrop, and then go back up to here, and you're gonna pull that loop into and underneath all of that wrapping that we just did. Wow. And then we can just cut these two tails off. I actually feel like I did it a little high. I want the loop to be a little bigger than that. So you can just slide these gathering knots down. Okay, so now that we've got all of that done, we're gonna be separating out 3 sections of the yarn in groups. So they're gonna be 3 groups of 4 strands. So I'm gonna start working on one section, and then we're gonna kind of duplicate that pattern that I'm gonna do with knotting on the other 2 sections. Okay, so I'm gonna move these over there.
So I'm basically gonna do a pattern of a combination of a spiral knot and a square knot. And they're essentially the same thing, but it depends on which way you're knotting to determine if it's gonna become a spiral or if it's gonna stay a box. So I'm gonna start with a spiral. You guys have seen me do this in some of my macrame videos, which I'll link all those below if you guys wanna do some more intricate wall hangings or something. But basically, I have four strands here. The two on the outside are the only ones that you're going to mess with. The two in the center are always going to stay stationary. So you're gonna take your left strand, basically gonna make a number four. You see the four going down like that? And then your right strand, and it's going to go over, under, and then through the loop of your four. You're gonna make like a pretzel. And then to make the spiral, you're gonna do that exact same thing again. And it's going to spiral around those center pieces, those two center strands. And pull it up tight again. Number four, over, under, and through. And you can see it start to twist. So I'm gonna keep making the spiral knot until it comes back around, basically, until it starts to be at the front again, probably eight times. So you can see it made a spiral. And then, so then I'm gonna just skip over a little bit of space and then do a box knot, which is gonna be the same thing, make a number four, and go over, under, and through, and pull it to where you want it to be, which I'm gonna be right here. And then, basically, you're telling the spiral, no, 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 stay in place. So you're gonna create the box knot, which is gonna be backwards. So make a backwards number four, over, under, and through. And then that box stays in place. I think I'm just gonna do one of those and then maybe do another spiral here. Okay, so you guys are gonna totally laugh at me. I changed my mind. I changed the pattern, but you guys know how to do the knots. So I'm doing one box knot with a little bit of space underneath, and then two box knots and a little bit of space, and then a spiral. So then it kind of like tears. Okay, so here is the finished pattern. So I'm just going to duplicate that onto the other two sets of four strands, and then we're gonna keep going. So now that I got all of them identical, and I had spent a little bit of extra time making sure that they were somewhat aligned, even though they're gonna be spread apart and you're not gonna really tell, this will sit in here, and then these will be like on around the sides. We are basically going to be taking the left two and the right two and attaching it to its macrame neighbor. And then I'm gonna grab like this one, and then these two are gonna be knotted together. So I'm gonna do a double box knot, or maybe just a single box knot right here on the side. Right where I had measured, I'm gonna do a box knot here. Okay, so we need to do that to the other two friends. So now this side, this side becomes friends and gets married to this side. And now we only got two sides left, so. Okay, so I'm gonna do that whole, now that I have all of these guys married together, I'm gonna do that same thing one more time with just a little more space. So I'm gonna take these two from this guy and then marry him with his friend with a box knot. And then do that two more times on the other two. Okay, so that's done. And it kind of looks like a web. You can kind of see how they're kind of attached now like that. So now we need to finish off the end with another one of our little gathering knots. So we need another 2 foot of this little guy, this macrame strand. So we're gonna make that little teardrop again. So grab the end, make a little loop like that, and then put it right on top, and then keeping that little guy exposed, we're gonna wrap around. turns around until you get down to that bottom loop, and then go through the top of the loop, and then you're gonna go back up to this tail that we left exposed, and then it's gonna pull that underneath. Wow, like that. And then we're gonna cut those two tails off, and then we need to cut all of our ends where we want them. So, and then cut them all to the same length. So I'm gonna fray the end of this because I really like the way that that looks. To do this, I just use Kinsley's dog brush. And I did this in my ornament video too when I did some tassels. And you just kind of start at the bottom and literally just brush it out. This makes all of those little strands separate and it looks more frayed. Okay, so now we just have to put this guy, I'm gonna hang him here, put our planner inside of it. So just slipping it in. Oh, wow. Okay, what do you guys think? Oh, wow. Now we just need a really pretty plant to go in it.
Shopping, 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 shopping.
This little quick macrame tutorial video. I'm gonna be working on a very large project, a room makeover project, over the next couple of days. So you guys are gonna see that very soon. And yeah, if you guys like this video, definitely hit the like button below. If you're new to my channel, I post new home decor and DIY videos every Sunday for sure, but a little more often during this month of December. So definitely hit the subscribe button below and the little bell notification button so that you guys know exactly when I upload, because it is more often this month so that you guys can know when that happens. And we'll see you guys in a couple of days. Oh. Bye guys.